You're exactly right. Dave sounds great, doesn't he?
Yeah, and I got to say, it's great to hear Dave, because what Star says is true. There's never, Bruce, honestly, a week goes by that somebody, someone in our audience doesn't say, Steve, how's Dave doing? And it's great to hear that he's doing so well. But I have to say just one thing, and I'm not trying to take this over, but I was watching Bill and I was watching Dave and all the others. And, you know, they really are the giants of our business, not even just here, but Dave Wright and Bill Jessam and those who started this program are the giants of Canadian broadcasting.
Absolutely legendary. Now, we should point out that the birth of Live at 5 was really, it was your TV debut as well.
Well, I think I wouldn't be on television were it not for Live at 5. Dave and Dick Pratt knew that on the Live at 5 magazine, they wanted to have somebody who came on and shot their face off, you know, with an opinion every day. And by the way, Gary Campbell, who's here, and George Reeves, and Kevin Nickel, they all shot those commentaries, or some of these guys did. The idea was to have a thought piece or a provocative opinion piece. And I was doing a phone-in show on the radio station in Halifax, and Dave and Dick Pratt and Harris Sullivan said, you know, why don't you come on and do it on TV? So I did, and I probably wouldn't be on TV were it not for it. So thanks, guys, very much for that.
The rest is history. You know, a lot of people point to Celebrate the Maritimes. We referenced that earlier as one idea that really helped the show connect with Maritimers. What do you remember about Celebrate the Maritimes?
Well, I'll tell you what I really remember, and I even remember it to this day, is where to find a liquor store and a bathroom in every city and town of the Maritimes. Because we were, well, Murray River, PEI, Lewisburg. We visited over the years that Laura Lee and I and Nancy Regan and I did the Celebrate programs. We were in, I think, 65 different communities in the Maritimes. We had, you know, the fabled Maritime hospitality in both official languages. That was just unbelievable. I mean, and for a kid who grew up here to actually get to see all of these places and to fly in a helicopter or on a fixed-wing pontoon plane and land in the harbor at Lewisburg and on the St. John River and so on.
Hard to believe we were ever that young.
Now I look at him and I wonder who is he.
Yeah. That's right. Weather always played a role in these remote shows as well, didn't it?
Well, sure. When the weather was great, the crowds were great. When the weather was bad, well, we put on, you know, funny-looking yellow slickers and umbrellas.
Did the show anyway.
We did the show anyway.
What do you think? What is it about Live at 5 that's really connected and continues to connect with Maritimes?
Well, certainly, I think Dave said it very well. The talent that we have here at CTV is enormous. And we often speak of the people on the other side of the camera. They don't get nearly enough credit, our technicians in this room, in our control room. But everybody works at this TV station. I mean, it takes, as you know, a lot of work to put television on the air. And there are a lot more people you never get to see than, you know, us. So I think we've had great talent at our TV station. But I also think we've had a great relationship with the viewers. And to be quite honest about it, most of the really innovative ideas, or a great many of them, on this program came from people at home.
Right at home,
who wrote in and said, why don't you do this? Why don't you try that? They still do it via email and telephone. We get great ideas from them. And so there's a partnership there that has really defined the tone of it.
You co-hosted for 7 years. You've interviewed in that time some of the biggest names around. Oprah. Got to ask you about Oprah. That's got to be one of the biggest of the day.
I couldn't believe when we actually got Oprah to come on from Chicago for a half hour, which was apparently unheard of. We said we wanted to do her live from the Harpo Studios in Chicago, and she came on. This was at the time when CTV had just acquired Oprah, and it was a big deal that we were getting the Oprah Winfrey Show. And to launch it, our producers and our management here at the TV station said, why don't we get Oprah to come on? And we asked, and she said yes, and she was on for an entire half hour.
And that's the real deal.
And she did confess during that interview, because she said, you know, where are you? And I said, well, we're actually out to the east of Maine. And Oprah Winfrey said, I didn't know there was anything to the east of Maine.
She may know by the end of this. All right. Yeah. Thank
you. She was a delight to interview. She's a wonderful woman.
And as are you. A wonderful interview.
Well, thank you.
We made history right there.
I've worked my entire career not to be a wonderful woman.
A wonderful
so I appreciate
woman?
That.
Steve Murphy. Here's Star Dawson.
You're a wonderful woman too. Bruce.
Yeah, that's right.
Here is a wonderful woman. Star.
Here's Star.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys. And now-